It is good to be back once again to this famous mining town, Dankwa, for the launch of an important initiative of the Akufo-Addo government for the mining sector, the National Alternative Employment and Livelihood Program. A program designed to help alleviate the hardships of those affected by government's efforts to sanitize the mining industry. Ladies and gentlemen, with Ghana having been blessed with so many minerals, it is not surprising that mining has always played a significant role in our lives. For centuries, our minerals have been the attraction for investors, adventurers, and fortune seekers. Many foreign thrones and crowns are adorned with the gems taken from our lands, not always through straightforward means. The pursuit of gold in recent years through the phenomenon of illegal mining of Dalanse has reduced many of our forests to degraded lands and some of our rivers to polluted water bodies. It is no wonder, therefore, that some describe these minerals as curses instead of the blessing and good fortune they should be. In order to help curb the menace of illegal small-scale mining, the Small-Scale Gold Mining Law 1989, PNBC Law 218, was passed to regulate small-scale mining and to facilitate Ghanaian participation in the mining industry. This law prohibited the use of explosives and heavy machinery in small-scale mining in favor of less expensive methods. Today, without any form of license, some Ghanaians are conniving with foreigners to mine everywhere with explosives and heavy machinery, including in forest reserves and water bodies.